Okay, MGK dissing reaction channels. Unfortunately, part of this freestyle has been spoiled for me based on the people that I follow, but I still haven't heard the freestyle, so this is still a first time listen reaction. But I have seen the screenshot from this video with the subtitles at the bottom saying that he watches reaction videos. And then I also saw the tweet where he was talking about some reactors getting the bar about shining like Johnny with Johnny from The Shining and that bar, but missing the other double meaning from that bar with Johnny Dang and the jewelry. And I'm one of those guys. I didn't catch that bar. When I do reactions, it's always a first time listen because I want to challenge myself to catch as many bars as I can the first time I hear a song, so I'm obviously gonna miss some. But for a first time listen reactor, I feel like I do a pretty solid job most of the time. I don't know, let's test my knowledge right now. Now obviously this is gonna be copyright claim, so we're gonna sit back, drink some Mountain Dew out of a nice little cool coconut cup, and let me tell y'all about it. Shout out to the homies over at Bespoke Post for sponsoring this video. They are a monthly membership club that delivers you a box of awesomeness of top shelf goods from under the radar brands. It's free to join and you can skip a month or cancel at any time. 90% of the products come from small brands, many of which are based right here in the US. Every month, they will introduce to you a new box based on this quiz that you take of a bunch of really cool stuff. This can range from camping gear, clothing, knives. It's all based on this quiz that you take. So they're not gonna send you some stuff that you're not interested in. Every box of awesome has around $70 worth of items in it, but you only pay a fraction of that cost. And you also get to preview your box before they send it out. So before they send it out, you get to see exactly what's coming in your box and decide if you wanna keep it, if you wanna swap it for a different box, or if you just want to skip that month entirely for no charge. One of the boxes that they sent me is this compact camping chair because I love the outdoors and I love going camping. And then boom, nice little campfire chair that was wrapped in this tiny little bag. And I'm a big dude. This thing is holding my weight no problem. Another box I got is called the K. It comes with two coconut cups that just make me want to fill it up with some rum, and I don't even drink rum. It comes with a jerk blend and a jerk brine so I can make some chicken jerk. And it even comes with a nice little domino set. So when we're sitting around the campfire in my camping chair and I'm making some Caribbean jerk, drinking out of my coconut cups, I can also play some dominoes. And if you guys are interested in this and want to help your boy out, go download to the description and click the link and use promo code CRIP20, all capitalized, and you can get 20% off of your first box of awesome. Or you can just go to bespokepost.com/crypt20. But all right, let's do this. I've been challenged. This is MGK and Doughboy Killer Cam freestyle. All right, let's go.
From the homie's backyard, and today we got Dovey.
I still want to know who the homie is. Whose fucking backyard is this?
Yeah.
Oh, we got that camera on beat.
Really?
Okay. Bro, I will say mad respect for these beat selections. They've all been dope. OG beats for these freestyles.
First 48 game, man. Step on everything.
Holy fucking necklaces, this guy. Okay. Okay. Water on a wrist. It's a nice little street term for being wet. Try to see you're going to get drenched. See, it gets annoying when you gotta break down every single fucking bar in a reaction channel. All right, I'm not gonna do this.
That shit, you gon' get drenched. Barely shoot cause I got rich, but still dropped 30 off the bench. Should've upped that bitch quick, but he was too late. 40 hitting that bitch like a shine of blue face.
Nice. 40 hitting that bitch, 40 caliber gun, hitting that bitch like Chris Sean to Blueface, Christian Rock. Nice little domestic violence gun bar intertwined. Always fun to rap about that shit.
40 hitting that bitch like a shine of blue face. You ain't with the shits that you can't spend with us. You ain't murder gang, can't name no gangster shit you did with us. Nigga better duck, see me lift it up. He tried to score on me like DraftKings, I blew his ticket up.
I like this guy's energy. You ain't with the shits you can't spend with us. Shit goes down the toilet and spins. But if you ain't with the shits, nice little street term. If you ain't with the shits, if you ain't bad, you can't be with us, bro. You can't roll with us. Okay, I like this guy's just demeanor. He's got the confidence exuberating from him.
Man, bandit rolling loud. Reaching for my chain up this bitch blowing the crowd. Running chicken up.
All right, we got hella gun bars.
Style. Big step with 2 feet in. Don't get out of bounds.
That's a good bar.
Dragged him out the club like I'm security. Damn, I forgot I rap. Damn. My front line. BC don't sit in the back. Put you on a shirt for cheap and look like TJ Maxx.
Ooh, I like that. Never. Another murder reference, another murder bar, but put you on a shirt for cheap. Talking about rest in peace in memory of on the t-shirt. You know, everybody's heard that bar a million times, but it's still kind of cool to just toss it in there every now and again. TJ Maxx has notoriously cheap clothing.
My nigga, never met Cuddy. Ain't saying he ain't for Cleveland, I just never met Buddy. Demon, not a preacher, I can't go like Corey Bates. A nigga played and I'ma go, I like you money. Glizzy on my hip, I up the switch, I ain't gon' miss. I don't miss when I'm on hits, and I damn sure don't miss a bitch. We on your strip, bet your set dip. I seen that blitz, thought I was recording. I'm on my story, you saw that flashlight on that blitz.
Y'all should listen when I'm spitting.
Not bad, not bad. A lot of gun bars in the freestyle, which, you know, it's fine. It's a freestyle. You're not trying to walk away with something super profound. But I would prefer a little bit of a topic switch with a freestyle. Like, there's something else to rap the style about. It's freestyle, not gun bar rap. Like, you rap about gun bars, but then rap about something else. Just kind of throw a little bit more variety in there is all I'm asking if it's a freestyle. That's all I'm asking for.
Oh, really? Y'all should listen when I'm spitting.
It's supposed to be
really
free of style.
There's a difference between who's authentic and portraying something. There's a difference between independence and your label front. Like, there's a difference between being legendary and just having your name buzzing. Blood don't mean nothing. I'm closer with Slim than my real cousin. Fuck 12, JoJo's down 13. That's
a dope bar right there, too. Like, I'm closer with Slim than my real cousin. And obviously, there's a nice little fucking beef ongoing for years. So he's basically saying that even though my cousin's blood don't mean nothing. I'm closer to Eminem, which is literally one of my most known enemies, than my actual cousin. Like, that's raw right there. I'll fuck with that.
Fuck 12, JoJo's down 13. That's a baker's dozen. Ate a chicken leg,
right,
playing chicken
head
while her face thumping. The friction from it make noise like when the cricket's legs rubbing. I was aiming for a mouth, couldn't control it. Now her hair crunchy. Left and hit Dover Street Market. Spent the hundy. I'm a serious.
Okay, MGK has no aim when it comes. I like the information I'm walking away with here.
Dover Street Market, spent the hundy. I'm a serial fashion killer like Ted Bundy. I spend it all on Saturday, I could be dead Sunday. I'm really nice with this. I watch reaction videos, you miss some bars, so I need you to listen twice to this. Like, if I say I'm a monster, I don't mean metaphorically. I mean, I'm genetically spliced with it. Lyrically Christ with it. Fear of God, Nike fit. My boy Bean used to have crack inside his Nike kicks. That's not my lane. Give me a beat, don't care what type it is. I'm about to recite viruses on whoever's mic this is.
I'm really enjoying the rhyme schemes. That's what I was really paying attention to right there, was the cadence that he had and just how intricate the rhymes were right there. It's actually pretty nice. If you put a highlighted rhyme scheme to that, it's probably a lot of different colors, a lot of inner rhymes, a lot of end rhymes, tying it all in together. So not bad at all right there. Talking about, that was the reaction bar right there. I need you to run it back and listen twice to this. Your boy doesn't listen to anything twice when he reacts to it, though. So that's not a me, dog. Like, if it's not a me, I'm chilling. No, I mean, I can understand that, bro. Like, it is annoying when you work so hard on a song, you work to really write something intricate in a double meaning bar, and then somebody will discredit you saying that you can't rap, or that, yeah, it's fine, but like, bro, you missed half the shit that I wrote because you're not really listening hard for it. So I do get it from that standpoint, but I also get it from a listener standpoint. Like, I don't want to fucking have brain surgery when I'm listening to a song. Like, I don't want to sit there and try to really fucking pick everything apart, because you lose the love for music that way. I mean, I used to react to videos like that where I would try to absolutely hit every single fucking bar. I would pause every 5 seconds and show every bar that I heard just so people knew that I was hearing these bars, and that it makes you lose the love for it. It really does. So I see it from both angles. Regardless, so far, a lot of cool, really good rapping in this. I don't want to discredit anybody. There's really good rapping in this. There's some double entendres hit. There's inner rhyme schemes hit. There's different flow switches from everybody on a really fucking dope beat. This Cameron beat is really, really solid.
My boy Bean used to have crack inside his Nike kicks. That's not my lane. Give me a beat. Don't care what type it is. I'm about to recite viruses on whoever's mic this is.
Yeah, that's a
y'all
dope rhyme scheme.
My flowers, but y'all hyping this. Ears must be damaged. Someone Mike Tyson did. The flow's tight like ice.
Mike Tyson did. I like that. The way you spin that off. Obviously, Mike Tyson bit Evander Holyfield's ear. Bit that shit off, dog.
Ears must be damaged. Someone Mike Tyson did. The flow's tight like Ice Spice's fit. But my Rick's loose like my 4X white tee in 2006. I known Doughboy since 2006. I really opened for Gucci Man in 2006. I used to drop songs and only get 2,000 clicks. Now I can stack plaques up like 2,000 bricks. All my boys self-employed. Got the best.
Lost me at first when you rhymed 2006 with 2006 three times in a row, and none of the inner rhymes really led into that. But finishing off with only used to get 2,000 clicks, now I got like 2,000 plaque bricks, or stack up 2,000 plaques like bricks, because, you know, bricks stack up to build a fucking house. You get that. But that was dope.
Up like 2,000 bricks. All my boys self-employed. Got the banks, no Lloyd. At the crib, lot of toys.
Got the banks, no Lloyd. Lloyd Banks, cool bar right there. A lot of money
banks,
bars.
No Lloyd. At the crib, lot of toys. Got a kid, no Leroy. Got the
At the crib, lot of toys. That's a dope. That's a cool little flashy bar. Cause you know, a baby crib and there's toys with baby cribs, but at the crib, like his house. So just a quick little double bar in there if you're paying
boys
attention.
Got a kid, no Leroy. Got the fridge with LaCroix.
Got a kid, no Leroy. Kid Leroy, yeah.
Kid, no
Leroy. Does MTK actually have a kid? Does he actually have one, or is he talking about a goat? Because a baby goat is called a kid. Is he saying, like, I'm the goat? Is that the bar that he's referencing right there? Like, I got a kid, I'm the kid, I'm a goat. That's the super stretch that we got right there.
At the crib, lot of toys. Got a kid, no Leroy. Got the fridge with LaCroix.
There you go. See,
smoking
I like
loud,
this.
Fuck the noise. Use the throat, not
smoking
a
loud, fuck the noise. Reefer weed is also referred to as loud in the streets, but fuck the noise, loud noise. He's tossing in a bunch of doubles back to back right here. And it's the similar theme of like, I got this, no this. I got this, no this. Banks, no Lloyd. Kid, no Leroy. Loud, fuck the noise. Like, yeah.
She ate the nut like almond joy.
Hold on, let me go back.
Smoking loud, fuck the noise. Use the throat, not a voice. She ate the nut like almond joy. I got a driver, he pull up, go beep beep. Acting like I ever quit rapping. Y'all sleep, sleep. I wore some
okay.
And now he's thinking I'm sweet, sweet. We left the club and cooked his ass like street meat. Feeling like Cameron, turn the camera on. Look at the Jewels, repping the old boy, not the Jewel Santana song. I've had this number too
that's
damn long.
Right.
Don't hit me if it's not about money. I want my text green like Samsung.
Yeah. I like that bar too, because obviously a Samsung text to an iPhone, it turns green, but I want my text green because I want to talk about money. Money's green. Yeah, filled it up to the brim right there at the end with a lot of quick little double entendres. You know, she used her throat, not her voice. She sucked the dick and ate the nut like Almond Joy. Almond Joy's got the nuts in it, but the nut is in semen. Another MGK cum reference in the song.
I wore some pink and now he's thinking I'm sweet, sweet. We left the club and cooked his ass like street meat. Feeling like Cameron, turn the camera on. Look at the Jewels, repping the old boy, not the Jewel Santana song. I've had this number too damn long. Don't hit me if it's not about money. I want my text green like Samsung.
Yeah.
Nice.
You know what the fuck going on, man. Cleveland, stand up, man.
I would say this is probably my least favorite of the three freestyles that I've reacted to.
The biggest, man. You hear me? You
but it's not bad.
You want to make it through that city.
Gotta holler at them if you want to go through Cleveland. I was just in Cleveland not too long ago. I ate at a haunted house restaurant. It was really nice. Didn't holler at them though.
See you at the top. At ya.
Whose house is this, bro? I need to know. Fuck, I love this beat. Hey, I want to see more. I really do want to see more because one, like I said, I really fuck with the beat selection. Like, there's a plethora of classic beats to pick from to rap over, and he's picked some really OG classic ones and kind of introducing them to some fans of his that are younger and don't know what these beats are. So kudos. I actually fuck with that message right there. A lot of double entendres, a lot of rhyme schemes, a lot of cadence switches, everything that you look for in a cypher rap. So I fuck with it. Like I still fuck with it, even though, you know, obviously didn't catch every bar. I apologize. I don't catch every bar, but if you guys ever want me to do like a full in-depth bar breakdown, I would literally catch everything. I would catch stuff that the artist himself didn't even know that they did. I would just make the most random ass connections because you can make crazy ass connections when you really dive deep into every song ever. So don't make that happen. But that's it for this one. Love you guys. Appreciate you for stopping by. If you're still here, follow me on Kick. I'm streaming every single night at 7 to 8 o'clock Central Standard Time, playing some scary video games or some angry video games, just getting mad and scared at the same time. It's fucking great time. That's it. Love you guys. See you guys in the next video. Peace out.
Yeah, I'm out here trying to get it. Hey, each and every day. I don't care about nothing in my way. Yeah, I'm out here trying to get it. Hey, each and every day. I'll make it no matter what they say. Yeah, I'm out here trying to get it. Hey, each and every day.